The video that you're about to see, I took in the latter part of 2012, and I took it with a guest to my channel. Before we get into the video, I'd just like to point out that I refer a lot to the crown chakra here. Now, you have the mage in the center of the ritual. And I would suggest that within, say the Masonic circumstance, you actually have a mage in the center with the spirit orbs in the area, like say within the Masonic hall, around the mage, and that various elemental spirits, of which these are, can manifest into creatures such as griffins and the like. But so you have the mage in the center here with the chakras being sort of lit up, if you will, these etheric magnetic chakras. But I would suggest that you don't need the mage in the center. So we're going to talk a lot about this one here, about this little drawing that I did. And I would suggest that I was sort of a bit confused at the time. It's my point of view these days that you can take the mage out of the situation and have an altar in the center, and that you can have orbs and so forth at the altar and above the altar. Not only that, from the orbs can sort of emerge spirits, and you can sort of perhaps see them within the orbs also, strangely enough. So I'd just like to sort of point this out as we go into this video. A year ago, you know, they were sort of earlier times for me, but just keep that in mind as you see the video. Part of the complication is that there are different types of magic rituals with different stages to the rituals. And I have been told by a Mason that there are different rituals. Let's proceed. Regarding these, the pillars that are often represented here, what are your thoughts on these pillars?
The actual pillars represent the physical. The reason the elemental orbs are placed on top of the pillar is to show that they are of the physical. They're from the physical, but not of the physical. It's showing that these elementals are from the astral, and that to even perceive them, the magus or magician must raise his energy up to the first octave of the astral to even perceive those elementals. So it's saying that this is not a ritual for the uninitiated. You at least have to have initiated yourself to the astral to be able to begin this procedure, as those elemental orbs are on four pillars. The pillars have four sides. They represent the earth.
Could we describe these pillars as the Djed pillars?
In a way, yes. They're like Djed pillars, but actually those pillars go higher. The Djed pillars are different pillars than those, I'd have to say.
They go to... How high do they go, do you think?
Well, the Djed pillars, they're the pillars that go all the way to the third eye. So, yeah, where these pillars, that these pillars here only are in the physical, and they're the top... Their platform is in the astral. And so these orbs, these elemental spirits, are of the astral, but connected to the physical.
So in a ritual, could you have the actual structure there, the, say, stone pillars in place?
You could have a stone pillar or a wooden plinth. Is either or is often used in an actual ritual to symbolise those pillars.
Are you suggesting that people should learn how to and partake in these rituals?
Well, first off, I'm definitely saying that people already are partaking in this ritual. Every breath, the cosmic energy manifests physicality through this ritual. Each of us every moment are engaged in this ritual. What I am suggesting is that all of us can consciously engage in this ritual rather than unconsciously as we do, and by doing that, well, we can come into our power as a community. Because at the moment there are only small groups who are consciously enacting this ritual, and those groups are also linked to the control systems around the planet. So once all of us as aware souls actively engage this ritual, then we've got a whole new potential as a people.
In the earlier throes of me, in my discovery of the ritual, I drew this diagram here. I'm just wondering about your thoughts on this diagram without going into too much detail, but the diagram itself, in relation of the sun and the zodiac and the outer planets and moon for that matter, to do with the spirit orb, and also the spirit orb's relation to the divine chakra.
Mm-hmm. Well, the spirit orb directly relates to the Saraswara, or divine, or thousand-petal chakra.
Does it move independently from that chakra?
That chakra never moves.
Right, but the spirit orb does move up and down.
No, not really. In fact, as you've drawn here, you've extrapolated the sun and the zodiac out of the spirit orb.
Yes.
Now, because what you've drawn here is a stage of the process. In fact, the spirit orb contains the whole thing.
Yep.
It seems like during a point of the ritual, the spirit orb is moving up and down, but it is not. The spirit orb stays in situ, and it is the awareness nexus of the magician that moves up and down. By focusing on the spirit orb, it loosens that nexus from the physical. And so all of what you've drawn here, these extrapolations, are stages of the ritual in order to get the magician or magus to the position of having his awareness leave his human form. In fact, the spirit orb contains the whole thing. We could draw an all big aura around it, like if we had the Kabbalah. We'd have Ein Sof, this big egg around the whole thing is the real spirit orb. This here is the awareness of the magician, and we can see this line here and this line here. These are key points and key abysses that the magician's awareness must go through. And all of this, these things that you've extrapolated, the sun and the zodiac and, of course, the planets and all of those things, that whole galaxy is inside an inner rim of the spirit orb.
Okay. So the spirit orb doesn't move up and down the chakras?
In the early stages, it seems to, but right. In fact, it is not.
Right.
It is, in fact, It is the awareness, which also is in the form of an orb. I'll call that awareness assemblage point, the assemblage globe. It moves up and down the system, or up and down the spine.
Yep.
When that awareness is at the top of the head, then full awareness of the full encapsulating spirit orb. When the awareness is, say, at the stomach chakra, the spirit orb seems to be moving and seems to be something above. It's only when awareness is fully placed at the point of Saraswara, or crown chakra, that the awareness of the magus blends with the energies of that divine, and then the awareness is of totality, of complete wholeness. So that's why the spirit orb can be drawn encasing the whole thing. Okay. And in that state, we call it Ein Sof Ur.
What is your description of the black sun? Or the sun? The sun and the black sun and the sun itself in regards to the ritual?
Right, we look at the sun, and it's a big mother in the physical. The black sun and the physical sun also has an aura in the astral. What we call the black sun is the sun in the middle of what we call it the Chindahash, which is the infinite space. It's the black sun in the middle of the heart chakra. And it's actually a sun on another world, where our physical sun has auras in all of these worlds. The black sun stops at the heart chakra. It doesn't have... We can't conceive it in the physical. We can't conceive it in the astral. We can't conceive it in the devachanic. It's only in the atmic, only in the plane of the heart. That's where it begins. It's like the sun that you see when you're standing in the Akashic temple. It's the sun that lights the Akashic temple. So it is a separate entity than soul. But indeed soul, our sun, has a chakra, a sheath, in all of the realms. This thing that we're calling black sun, it does not have a sheath in the physical, it does not have a sheath in the astral, it does not have a sheath in the devachanic. That's the only way I can really delineate the two.
Okay. Is there any difference between the spirit orb and the crown chakra?
You're using the spirit orb in lots of to delineate different things from what I can see.
Yeah, because
definitely there's no difference between the spirit orb and the crown chakra. But if we look at your diagram here, where you've got spirit orb, we've got the spirit orb here.
Yep.
There you're using it in a different sense. There it is equivalent more like the black sun.
Right.
And here I'd call that the black sun, and I'd put a big orb around the whole thing and call it the spirit orb.